Well, this is Jacob.
That's a lot.
Jacob, my husband.
My husband of 44 years. We were married in Kiev in 1967. And next year, our daughter was born. And now she is 43 years old. But at that time, we were so happy to have our daughter. Also, my dream was to have a son. And 6 years later, God gave us a son. We called him Nicholas by my father's name. My father's Hebrew name was Hona, but he called himself the Russian way, Kola.
Kola, is
Kola
short
means
from
short from Nicholas,
okay.
Nikolai. So when our son was born, we decided to give him my father's name, and we gave him the name Nikolai, which is in English sounds Nicholas. And when we got our citizenship, we, of course, put Nicholas in English. We also shortened our Russian name, last name, which was Chemirovsky. We shortened it when we got our citizenship papers, and we put Chemers.
Spell it.
Chemers. C-H-E-M-I. R like in Robert, S like in Sam.
Good.
Chemers.
Okay.
So we have daughter. Of course, she was married and she changed her last name.
Where does she live?
She lives after 18 years in San Francisco. She moved to Pennsylvania. Yes, and she lives in Pittsburgh now.
Okay. How about Jacob? You tell me about, can you tell us about your son, a little bit about him? And
first I'll tell you about myself. I was born
good
in Belaya Tserkov. It's a town near Kiev, about 60 miles from Kiev. And at the time when I was born, before the war, it was a real town, a small town. It grew up only later, after the war in the 60s, it became a city. It started growing, it developed some industry, metalworking plants, and it had factories, and it population grew, and in 1957 I was drafted to the Soviet Army because that was mandatory. Everyone who reached 18 was drafted to service.
For how long?
For 3 years. Well, I was lucky because before me it used to be 5 years, and during World War II it was even more, sometimes indefinite, because they didn't have replacement. A lot of young men were perished during the war, and they had they needed to keep up their armed forces, and they needed young men to serve. And then, when of course, life got better and the population grew up, so they made it still mandatory, but 3 years. And so I served 3 years in the army, and then when I came back home, still in Belaya Tserkov, Belaya Tserkov, I forgot to tell you, Belaya Tserkov translates as White Church. That has a meaning, White Church. And
how do you spell that?
Belaya Tserkov? Or Belaya Tserkov, it's B-E-L A-Y-A, and T-S-E-R-K-O-V.
Wow.
Белая церковь.
Two words.
Two words. Yeah.
Okay.
And after I came from service, I of course I got I found a job at a metal working plant, and I was doing working on a turning, I don't know how to say it, turning machine. It's a metal working machine. And then they didn't have enough work, so I found another job at a shoe factory. And then I decided that I need some trade. So I went to a technical school and graduated as an electrician.
When did you
Here it's like industrial college.
Industrial college, yes.
Okay.
Industrial college.
Okay.
And when I graduated from the electrical school, I was directed to work in Kiev. And when I worked in Kiev for about about 5 years, then I met my beautiful wife, and of course.
Let me just explain a little the system, how the education system worked in Soviet Union. You did not have to pay for education.
It's free.
Instead, they paid you a stipend that
they
you could go to school.
Mm-hmm.
Through the whole school, they paid you stipend.
That's good.
That you could live on. But after you finished your education, they would send you
wherever
to places where they needed you the most. And you were supposed to work at these places for 5 years.
To work out for
to
what
work
they did for you.
Where they sent you.
To pay for your
to
education.
To pay for your education, you would work at the places. Sometimes they would send people far away from their homes, from their family, and they would work 5 years. And then you could leave that place and find the job wherever you want to, wherever
you
was
can find the
could
job.
Find the job.
That's pretty good.
So because Jacob was a straight A student, three of the students of this school were sent to three largest cities of the Soviet Union, Moscow, Leningrad, and Kiev. Three largest cities. So Jacob got Kiev. This is where we met.
Yeah, that's he probably, lived, God knows what he's doing.
He lived in a dormitory for a year before he met me. And I lived with my mother. So when we got married, we all three of us lived in apartment, in a small apartment. But my mother was writing letters to the government, to the local government all the time, asking for a larger apartment. And finally it was granted when our daughter was about 2 years old. We received from government larger apartment. So it was four of us now. And still it was not enough. My mother continued writing letters. Continued. Then when we did receive a larger apartment, first apartment was one bedroom apartment. When we got married, we lived in one room. It's not one bedroom apartment, but one room where it was two beds, our bed and my mother's bed.
And these neighbors.
And we had a neighbor, which a roommate they called neighbor. We used the same kitchen, the same bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. You and took it, turns it, in the bathroom.
Yes. Took turns. Two strange families would live in one apartment.
Wow.
This is how it worked in Soviet Union.
Wow.
But after my mother was applying and asking for a different apartment, a larger apartment, finally we were given a larger apartment.
Yeah, but why did they give us an apartment? Because your father perished?
Yes, because my mother applied that we are a family of a perished soldier. This is why, after 20 years after the war.
No, and because we formed a family, and the apartment was too small for a family, so finally...
Finally we got a larger apartment. It was one-bedroom apartment. Now we had a living room and a bedroom. I don't even remember how it was.
Yeah. We had two bedrooms.
And the last apartment.
Two bedrooms and the living room.
Yes, we had two bedrooms and the living room and the kitchen and no neighbors.
It
no
was all for us.
No roommate.
No neighbors. It was all yours.
All ours, that's yes.
So you didn't tell me how you met. Which a blind date? How did you meet?
No.
That's a story in itself.
I was working at the, how you call this, at the shop.
You had a
I
job.
Was, I, you don't have things like this here. It was called Atelier. No. It's
a little shop to repair clothes.
To repair clothes or to make new clothes.
Not a tailor shop.
Tailor shop.
Yes. And he came, he is short. So he every pants he bought, he was supposed to shorten. This is where we met.
Okay.
I was in charge, I did bookkeeping, I did the payroll for this shop. And I was in charge to get
receivable,
payable, and to order the materials for the shop. And also I was in charge. I had to walk to the main office for the payroll, to bring in the payroll and distribute it among the workers.
That's an important job.
Walking.
It is.
It's important job because we didn't have a check, we didn't have checking accounts, we didn't have a credit card, everything was cash.
It was paid
so,
in cash.
So paid
salary
in,
was
so
cash.
So wow. I had to walk
That's
to
a,
the office.
How far?
About a few blocks.
Not too far.
Not too far, but still it was a few blocks.
You could have been
and
robbed.
You are right. This is the key to the story. This is the key to the story. Jacob was a customer at this shop. I saw him twice. Then the day of the payroll came in, and I was walking with a big amount of cash in my purse with the salary for a half a month for all the workers.
Including yourself.
Suddenly,
course, yes.
Suddenly somebody pat me on the shoulder, and I was also always so worried that nobody stopped me to rob, that I was like
frightened. You were frightened.
I was frightened always, and rushing to get the shop as soon as possible, and suddenly on my way somebody pat me on the shoulder. I looked up, and it was Jacob. I looked at him surprised.
Yeah,
he was.
I became a guard.
He became a guard, but I didn't know what he had in his mind. I had no idea. Maybe he was going to rob me. Anyway, he asked me if what time do I finish the work, and I told him what time I will be off, and I thought he will leave, but he walked with me up to the shop. To this shop I worked at.
Good friend. Yeah, good guy.
And then he asked me if he can walk me home. And I told him that I live far away. I have to take a subway to go home. He said, oh, it's okay. I'll walk you anyway.
I was alone. So
you took the subway.
Yes.
To her house together.
Yes.
Then so a this is walking.
Yes.
Not too bad.
Then he came again and again after work, and again after work. And 2 weeks later, he proposed. Can you imagine something like this?
How many
Just
2 months?
2 weeks.
Oh, 2 weeks later.
2 weeks later, he what? Proposed.
He saw a good thing when he saw it. He had good taste.
Yes.
He didn't want to lose you.
Probably.
Not only this, she knew a lot of poetry. And she was telling me all these poems.
Yes, he liked to listen to poetry. Yes.
Oh, that nice.
Yes.
Wow.
And it was very romantic.
I was recycling.
You know?
I was recycling the poetry. And he was listening.
You know,
Pushkin, famous poets. Pushkin and Lermontov and
others, yeah, not so
Mayakovsky,
famous, but,
famous Mayakovsky, Pushkin,
yeah,
Lermontov,
yeah.
Nekrasov, and other famous Russian poets.
No, like in Britain, they used to have Shakespeare,
and we have
and Pushkin.
Pushkin was
is
Russian
Shakespeare because he was writing poems, like novels. In poetry.
Wow. Novels in poetry.
And it was so nice. She used to say
it was
so nicely. So
the thing is that in Russia they only write rhymed poetry.
Yeah.
That's nice.
Rhyme.
That is nice.
Yes.
That is.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yes.
Yeah, like
and
that.
Here in America you can just put a text and call it poetry. In Russian it had to be.
No, poetry is poetry. It's different from prose.
Yes, but they would write it in a
column. Yeah.
In a column and call it poetry. And it doesn't rhyme.
Uh-huh.
But in Russian language almost
when it rhymes,
all
it's more beautiful.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes,
easier
it is.
To listen to and
yeah.
understand. And
yeah, it sounds like a song.
Like
a song.
It sounds like a lyric. It sounds close.
Yeah. Russians had very, very many
talented
poets.
Yeah.
Yes.
And
before maybe
revolution
and
after revolution.
And many, many, many of them were of Jewish nationality.
Yeah,
who wrote in Russian.
And the movie producers and
movie producers in Russia.
In Russia were
Russia
Jewish.
Was
Jewish.
Yeah.
Like Hollywood here.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
Very similar.
A different structure because Hollywood is a private organization.
And it was belonged to government.
To government.
State. Yeah. Everything belonged to government.
So I wonder if some of those Russian songwriters or poets were killed.
Oh, yes. Yes, they were
that's
killed.
That's another story.
Yes, it's another story. It's a big, big story.
Okay, I think we got enough of it.
Okay.